Hello, vinyl community. Good morning. Bradley here. I just want to show you a couple albums today. It shouldn't take too long, as long as I make my story short. The other day, I decided to go to Fort Wayne, which that's where my favorite record store is, Wooden Nickel. And also Classic Stereo is the hi-fi shop that I bought my receiver and speakers from. So I was interested in maybe buying a new phono cartridge. So therefore, I did not want to stop at Wooden Nickel and spend any money on records. I thought, just get a photo cartridge. So I went to Classic Stereo and asked Greg if he had any suggestions. I said, well, I listen to a lot of jazz, whatever. And so he had a couple cartridges, and one was a discontinued one. So he said, this may not be in particular a step up from my current cartridge, but it would be a sideways step, probably up a little bit, with a different, completely different sound. Now my older cartridge, it kind of rolled the highs off, you know, whereas this newer cartridge, it doesn't really roll that treble off. It keeps that. So anyhow, I thought, I'll take it. And so we started talking, and he asked me if I had ever heard the album Super Session by Al Kooper, Mike Bloomfield, and Stephen Stills. And I told him that no, I have not. Although on the VC, I've seen a couple people show this and they commented on what a great album it is. So he gets on the phone. I said, what are you doing? He said, well, I'm calling. He said the name of the guy, see if he has his record. Okay. Well, it ends up he called Wooden Nickel and was talking to Tim, the manager over there. So anyhow, they did have this in stock, used. And so anyhow, I went over to Wooden Nickel and picked this up. I'm very happy with it. Like I said, it was recorded in 1968, I believe somewhere in the middle of 68. And at this time, Mike Bloomfield had just left Electric Flag, I believe. And Al Kooper had just left Blood, Sweat, and Tears, which he had founded just the previous year, maybe, before. And Stephen Stills had just left Buffalo Springfield. So the story on this is that Al Kooper decided to record. So he booked 2 days at a recording studio, and he asked Mike Bloomfield if he wanted to come over and jam and do some recording. So Bloomfield came over, and I think there were a couple members of Electric Flag, which were the drummer, maybe a bass player or something. And so they recorded some songs. Now the next day, Bloomfield did not show up. Al Kooper could not get a hold of him. So he calls Stephen Stills up and asked if he wanted to come over and do some recording. So Stills said, yeah, sure. So he came over. So this album, Side One, is with Mike Bloomfield. Now Side Two is with Stephen Stills. They do not play together. So actually there's two different sounds on this album. This album is worth it, probably just for the fact that it has a couple songs where Bloomfield really just plays hellacious blues on here. Now on the other side, Stephen Stills does like a long version of Season of the Witch. This is really fantastic, and this copy sounds beautiful. It plays beautiful. I think I read where when they recorded this, it only cost like $13,000, basically just for studio time and whatever, mix down time or whatever, to record this album. And it turned out to be a gold record. So somebody made their money back on this album. And especially on side one, there are horns on here, which the horn arrangements were by Al Kooper. But these were overdubbed later on, more towards the mixdown, when they mixed the record down. Although you would not, it sounds like they're playing there live. Which, as I'm listening to this side right here, Stephen Stills, they have the horns in there too. And Al Kooper plays beautiful organ on this. It's fantastic. Since I'm talking about Al Kooper, I'll just show you the first Blood, Sweat, and Tears album. The only one he made with Blood, Sweat, and Tears. Which he formed Blood, Sweat, and Tears. But they had artistic differences, and he was out after one album, and David Clayton Thomas took over the vocal duties. Now, I love Blood, Sweat, and Tears, and actually, I have no preference between the two versions. I like David Clayton Thomas for his raspy, bluesy sounding voice. And I also like Al Kooper vocals. And on this particular album, I'm sure you've heard a couple of these songs. I Love You More Than You'll Ever Know, which is a fantastic blues type song. And also on the other side, I Can't Quit Her. So they've got a song by Tim Buckley, another one by Harry Nilsson, a Randy Newman song, and Al Kooper probably wrote maybe half of these particular songs. So I like that album. I like that album. kind of like a great combination. So that's it for today. Still cold, still snowy, freezing rain earlier. When will it ever end? Well, anyhow, that's it for me today. I hope everybody has a nice day. Catch you next time.